really kind of intimidating, I'm honest. The drizzle moved on to be wet sunshine. That heather stuff here, it's breaking me down. Hi everybody, today we are going up the north ridge of Kreis. The tour is called, the route is Ronna Kreis, a scramble grade 3. And yes, we are in Glencoe again. Over here we can see the curved ridge which goes up the Bucky. Then we have over here, next to this one, is the Pink Rib. Yeah, and this is the street down to Glen Etif. There are a lot of different ways up to Kreis. The North Ridge or Ronna Kreis is a grade 3 scramble, like the Ereglas route or something is also a grade 3 scramble. And you can also do the northeast route. And the difference of most of the routes is that the people park at the ski resort, which is here over the hill. And then they have a long walk through the bog. I decided that I park on the Glen Etif road. Then I have later on a river crossing. And tomorrow we're doing also a wild camp. We're going here up over the ridge and then we're coming down here. So that we basically walk like a horseshoe, which is, I think, super cool. I'm really looking forward to this one. I hope it's not too windy tonight. The forecast is between 40 and 50 kilometers per hour, plus some gusts, which are higher. So we will see. Right now we have like 18 degrees, a breeze, and tonight we should get around 1 or 2 degrees. Yeah, with the wind, the field temperature should be around -1, -2 according to the weather forecast. And here's the bridge where everyone photographs the Bucky. And this is where we go left and have a look if we can get onto the other side. And we are now heading just over here, where it is basically the foot of the North Ridge. Then we can start. Oh, looking forward to that. So we are now on the foot of the North Ridge. Holy guacamole, this is really kind of intimidating, I'm honest. It's also started just dribbling, so I will put on again my rain clothes and a bit late. I learn never, I guess. So we are all packed up and let us start with the scramble. I mean, right now I have the howling from the wind in my helmet and I have my first doubts that we will find a camp spot up there, which is us not blowing away. So probably should mentally prepare myself that we walk the ridge later on down in the dark. We will see. So I need to take my stripy hat off, just too warm. So it's a difficult decision, when it's so warm and so humid and then it starts raining. I mean, I feel like that I would walk in a sauna, like super warm. So the only thing I can do, or what I do right now, is that I walk slower, that I'm not sweating so much. And I have no trousers to change. I mean, I could just wear the rain trousers, probably would be the right thing to do. Can I show us? too reflective. But here's the picture where we can see the different routes which I found in the internet up Kreis. And you have seen the stars behind it. And the stars are apparently about the fuse you get in everything. So this should be a scramble 3 with 2 stars. But I'm pretty sure that we can avoid the difficult bits if it would get too difficult further up. At least this is what I read. And I have a look. Because again, I mean, I brought my own water. A clear advantage of a route where it is not as popular as others, that the stones are not polished. And this particular rock here is really grippy, it's really nice, and it feels like as it would be the same rock what we had over at the Bookie. And here so far always flat walking, and then some pretty good steps in it. And this is how it looks like. It's good. Pretty fair, but you have always the grassy bits in between, which makes it, from my point of view, just more difficult, because you don't know if the grassy bits hold or not. So as a rock by itself is a dream. It's really, oh, this one is loose. So far to be a dream. We are at 450 altitude meters, so 180 we did. It feels like that we are more or less already halfway, but this must be wrong. Should be more calm, but I'm honest. Walking to the foot of the North Ridge was so far more exhausting than scrambling up. When scrambling up here is with the adrenaline and you're busy in your head and everything, it gets somehow easier with the altitude meters. Let me know in the comments if you have the same. When the path gets more difficult, that is less exhausting for you or not. Would be interesting. So, and here We go up. Love it. It's so great. And I always wanted to do the Northridge. It's like, I don't know, for 5 or 6 weeks now, but I always did something else. Not sure if you can see it, but just behind us is a wee rainbow. Only in Scotland, yeah? I love it. It's with a big rucksack. Nothing. So I decided that we go rather here. Right now I'm not really decided if I should go just the green strip up to the top, or if it is the top, I don't know, or if I should go just here and here along. But I'm not sure if it goes down at the end or not. But I assume there's only one way to find out. Okay, actually two. Go one and have a look and go down and up, or straight go up and have a look. I think we should have a look. Otherwise we just climb down and walk up. Because I know myself, when I walked up and had a look, then I think I can't pause anymore to walk down for the scramble. And I avoided already further down the one which I showed you, which is too awkward with a big rucksack. For me it is too awkward, yeah. So let me just take this one and go now here in. So. This looks good. Doable. I'll chop my rainwaters up that I have better movement. I mean, you heard it probably in between. So, let's have a look how we do that. It's like all slaps. Sluffy, sluppy. Do honestly hope that we don't need to down climb this. Exhausting enough to get you up. Ha! Right decision. I love it. Over here is for sure already where we can go over. So there's no need to go the scramble down. Which I'm pretty pleased with it. It's, I mean, you can see it. I sweat already. It's so warm. But I don't trust the clouds. And as much as I hesitate to put rain clothes on, the same as taking them off. I put them too late on and too late off. But hey ho. This is how it is. I have clothes to change with me, plenty to drink, and some tortellini for later if we decide to camp on top. But right now we're out of the wind and I'm not really confident anymore. Maybe we find a sheltered spot, but otherwise just... It's as it is, we will see. And we came from there, just here up. And now we could go like on this side up, but I think they are not connected over here. So probably we should go here and have a look. Maybe we can even scramble up here. Not sure about it. I mean, for sure it's possible, but I think this is for sure more difficult than the one we did so far. Let's have a look. They are connected further up. The clouds are moving in. So I'm for sure not climbing on this side where the wind is. Huh. Look, that I join up here then the ridge and that we scramble over there. Just over direction to the top. sounds always so nice and simple. They're just crossing there over and then here and there. Oh man. You should have really stayed just on it, I think. So, and we are now just heading up here. But first, I need a plaster. I cut myself on a rock. It's really sharp. That's not so much. But it's rather a sharp rock than a polished one. Should have taken a bit more care for my thumb. Which I picked was for sure not a scramble 3. Rather a run, even ran. So, need to come back with a lighter rucksack. But yes, so many scramble and boulder possibilities. Amazing, really brilliant place for hands-on activities. Perfect holder. It was pretty handy. We got here some camera holder. So I believe we reached the side of Sronder Kreis. Beautiful view down Glen Ettef again. Yeah. The usual suspects in the clouds. And over here you can see the ski house and the lift. And right now we are at 890 altitude meters. I will now take my hat off, my stripy hat on again, get the trekking poles out, because here is more or less plain sailing up to Kreis. Here are some spots for camping, but I'm honest. Somehow I have the feeling that we should just walk the horseshoe. Maybe I decide differently, but right now I feel like more walking is too fresh and too early, and just carry on. Run auch Mo looks brilliant, or? Over here. up here. It's probably Chris, the first Munro for today. So what can I say to the Northwich or Srona Chris route, the scramble route? The route which I picked was for sure not a scramble grade 3, it was rather a 1 or less, I think, not sure. I will definitely do this again with a lighter rucksack. But really fun, brilliant stone, it's sharp, it's good grip. It feels more exposed than it is. You have really the feeling when you're scrambling there once that if you would slip, that you would slip down into the valley, which is nice. I like things like this, particularly when the rock is good. And I had only one loose rock, so brilliant. It's definitely to recommend to get up to a, yeah, I think it's rather an unexciting hill when you go via the resort or with a lift. But hey, everyone is so different. This is how it looks in front of us. It's really like, I think it's 150 altitude meters, what you can see in front of us. We are reaching the summit of Chris. It was so obvious that when we are reaching the top that the cloud is coming. I believe actually that this is the right peak over there. So anyway, we walked over it, and even when I'm not a Munro beggar, I still take them when they're on the way, yeah, don't get me wrong. Maybe it gets me in a wee while, the fever, not sure about that. Ah, such a fresh wind. Right now, when we're walking here through the ridge, the connecting ridge, we're looking for a cairn which marks basically the point where we need to descend. Yeah, the drizzle moved on to be wet sunshine. It shouldn't be too long, I think. At least this was the forecast. And as we know, the weather forecast for the Scottish Highlands is basically like a lottery. That looks definitely like a man-made little cairn. It should mark the way where we need to go down. Mammoth's dead. But you can definitely tell that here are more people walking, because the rock is definitely a tiny bit polished. But it's still so much grippier than at the Anoch Igach. The Anoch Igach was such a slippy stone. This is probably the granite here. This is the reason why it's still nice and grippy. I definitely decided now that I'm not doing a wild camp. I mean, hey ho, was a good training to carry all that water and food and stove and bibs and bobs, yeah, with me. But my wife had today also, she received her blue letter or her first vaccine today, and it's a good excuse, and I don't know. Have not really the feeling anymore for a wild camp today, and then there's no need to do it. Would have been tempting for tomorrow, because tomorrow the weather should be better. Maybe less wind, or probably less wind, and then I could have been flying that drone, and I quite enjoy that. What for amazing views. but the butt again, it's like, I don't know, don't feel it anymore. So we finished just the horseshoe now, which is also nice, yeah, like, for other people who want to do a day trip also, it's also good to see, probably it's definitely possible to do it. I mean, was a pity with the scramble bits that I had the big rucksack, but doesn't matter. It's good training for the next time. Oh man, look at this. Talking around, wandering around, and all. Amazing views. From the top bit over there, where we have been, down to here, is basically the lowest point, more or less, of this ridge. It is 190 altitude meters. And these ones we need to go up again on this side, that we reach our second mountain for today. Not much anymore. We're reaching the summit of Mir something. That was quite exhausting for me, the last bits. Mir is a nice pass with all stones. I like it much more than grass, but that's a good one. So you have a shorter look. Yeah, not much to see. Anyway, we are now heading basically here and always in this direction. Need to have a look that we find a more or less easy pass. Probably the best when we follow the normal pass down before this one goes off direction ski resort hut that we just had basically left. That seems to be already a good pass. Here's nicely, we can see we went here up this bit, all the way up to here, and then on top of this one, and now we're heading here. The tether stuff here, it's breaking me down. It's boggy, it's not as easy to walk through as it looks like, and it feels like it is for hours already. And we are just 1:15, we need it from the second Monroe to here, so it can't be, I know it, but it feels really like, holy guacamole. I think we need to head over here. It looks also that this is where we crossed, so in this direction. Quite a bit to go still. So. Finally, by the red rocks, they were so slippy and I missed the gray ones which I passed at the beginning, and I was too lazy to turn around. Stupid. Anyway, the whole trip is roughly 16.5 kilometers when we're by the car, 1,205 altitude meters. Probably the most interesting bit is with the north ridge of Stronach Kreis, and it took me like with the approach, with walking to it and everything, 2:45 with big backpack and not rushing myself to death. Probably you can make it in 2 hours 20 or something, I guess, to the top. So I will now go to the car, have a short rest and then drive home, have a bath and a beer. So I hope you enjoyed the tour and see you next time. Bye!